Hello and welcome to today's July 9th second stimulus check and stimulus package update. If you're a subscribed member of my community, hey, welcome back. And if you're not, consider subscribing right now. All right, I want to thank everyone who joined me last night for YouTube Live with Stephen Gardner. I hope you had a good time learning more about me, getting some ideas about money, and learning about the stimulus check and the stimulus package programs. Let me know in the comments, did you enjoy that? What else would you like to see? Should I do that once a week? Let me know, because if you don't like it, I don't want to do it. But if you like it, then I want to do more, because I had a great time. Okay, now I have some positive stimulus check information and some stimulus package updates that I'd like to go through with you today. President Trump was asked point blank, can Americans expect more stimulus checks from you? Trump said, the answer is yes, and we are working on this right now with Congress. President Trump went on to say that he wants more money than others want to do, but it will be significant. So I love that he said, yes, it's happening and we're working with Congress. But then he did point out that he wants more than others. Now, I do think he may be talking about some of the people that are in the Senate on the Republican side that he doesn't always see eye to eye with. But we will see what the final outcome of that is. But it's always nice to have the chief commander of the country saying that he wants more stimulus checks and he wants to get it out quickly for the people. President Trump then said the payroll tax is not up for negotiation. He believes it's important because people can take more money home from their job and not from government bailouts. So he doesn't want to cost the American people more tax money, but he does want to reward people who go back to work and that are already working with more money per paycheck. So I think that could be a good thing. President Trump is now saying he wants to see the next stimulus package passed by the Senate as soon as they come back. He wants a decision on his desk and ready to vote on in the first week of August. He also is saying he wants it to at least be a $1 trillion package. Nancy Pelosi was asked if this package was possible and the timeline for early August doable. She said, of course, it's doable. We will have a bill. So that's good as well. Let me know in the comments what you really think, though. Will this pass in late July, early August, or will it pass right before the election? Let me know your honest opinion. Gregory from the community says, why did President Trump and his administration say they wanted a $2 trillion package, and now they are saying they want at least a $1 trillion package? Stephen, are we just getting played? Great question, Gregory. I think it's important to remember the context and the timing of this. I think the $2 trillion number was thrown out when they were considering the $1 trillion infrastructure bill. So if you add a $1 trillion stimulus and a $1 trillion infrastructure bill, you get $2 trillion. So, but it was Congress who came out and said that they wanted to pass the infrastructure bill as a separate bill. So when you take the $2 trillion minus the $1 trillion, we're back to $1 trillion. So I don't think that they were lying. I think that Congress just decided to separate the two and have two $1 trillion packages. I hope that made sense. It's just a mathematical thing. Okay, now many politicians want the second stimulus to be more tailored to an employee's past income and not a blanket $600 for everyone. This would produce a more fair situation for those that are still working, and it would provide incentive to get back to work and would save the country a lot of money. However, I think that they will still do some blanket approach simply because it would be so time-consuming to take tens of millions of employees, crunch the numbers and data on what they used to make, and then send out individual money. I think what they'll do is they'll figure out a fair unemployment or back to work bonus, knowing that many jobs aren't coming back as quickly as they thought, and then I believe it will phase out over time. So if you're worried that July 31st, you're going to lose $600 cold turkey, I think you can take that fear off the table. Something will pass. We just don't know what it is yet. So I hope that that helps. Speaking of helping, would you give me a like so that YouTube will share this video with others? And please share this on social media. I love how much you guys like my videos, so I really appreciate you doing that. Okay, Congresswoman Angie Craig has said she would like to see a second round of money to businesses so long as they can show that there was a drop of at least 50% in their revenue. Now, other senators and people in Congress are saying that they also think that there should be a second round of money for the PPP program, but it should focus on small businesses. I think as the PPP data is coming out, they are seeing just how many celebrities and large corporations took advantage of that government money. So I do think that if there is a second round of PPP, it will definitely be more targeted and focus on small businesses. Steve Mnuchin of the Treasury said, "We are monitoring economic conditions closely. Certain industries, such as construction, are recovering quickly, while others, such as retail and travel, are facing long-term impacts and may require additional relief. We look forward to continued conversations with you to address these critical economic issues." $30 billion has already been returned from businesses that did not need the money or worried that their name would be disclosed. The average PPP loan was $107,000. I think we will see more PPP or EIDL money, especially for small businesses, in the next package or as a separate package. However, I do think that the Treasury will refine that, as I said earlier, and focus particularly on small businesses, most likely of 100 employees or less, or maybe even 50 or less. There were too many celebrities, politicians, and large well-known corporations that we know had money in the bank that still took advantage of taxpayer PPP money. So again, it wouldn't surprise me if we see more than $30 billion returned now that these names are being released. Now, as I wrap up today's video, I just want to remind you that you are amazing. So remember that, okay? Now, if today gets too hard, remember to breathe. You didn't cause this, you didn't ask for this, but you do have to go through this. And so try to go through it with courage, try to go through it with smile, but definitely go through it remembering that you are amazing. Hey, I appreciate you being in my community, and I'll see you on the next video.